And now it is time for the news, read tonight by Cass Stevens, who also wrote it. Good evening. Richard Branston-Pickles, who is normally pickle-brained, after flying around in a hot air balloon, has finally come up with a new and novel business idea. A new space tourism centre in New Brighton on Merseyside. The new space tourist centre has a subplot, though. Designed to offer expensive space flights to outer space for the rich and famous, or so it would appear, on the face of things, Branston-Pickles has invited a select number of wealthy customers to be his first high flyers. Baroness Margaret Thatched-Roof, fondly known as Metal Maggie, or Jaws 6, or even Rent-A-Gob, is the first on the list, invited by Branston-Pickles for a sinister reason of granting her a one-way ticket to the black hole, fondly called Hubble Bubble, which is the last pit stop for formerly earthbound witches and other famous figures who, like Baroness Thatched-Roof, are about as popular as a death at a christening. Baroness Thatched-Roof, who many have been awaiting the demise of since she was admitted to the Crom-Yell hospital in London, is taking up a much-needed NHS bed. And so Branston-Pickles decided that the best thing for all would be to ensure that Baroness Thatched-Roof got an in-advance send-off, which would save the UK taxpayer the cost of a begrudged state funeral. Recent attempts to help Baroness Thatched-Roof on her way to the great beyond have failed miserably. A woman by the name of Doreen Dosser, whose husband was made unemployed during the Thatched-Roof regime and who used to work on Liverpool docks, donned the nurse's uniform stolen from the staff changing room at the hospital and tried to trick Baroness Thatched-Roof into drinking what was supposed to be medication for swine flu, when in fact it was rat poison mixed with gunpowder taken out of a firework. Her attempt was foiled when Baroness Thatched-Roof drank the medication and promptly announced that she felt a whole lot better, since the shock had ironed out the wrinkles on her face, proving that she really is made from iron after all. Another failed attempt to help Baroness Thatched-Roof on her way was that plotted by Guy Fawkes Lift, who tricked Baroness Thatched-Roof into a wheelchair on the pretense of being taken for tests in another part of the hospital. He wheeled her into a lift and then into a crate at the rear of the hospital, which he then locked her in, after which he lifted the crate using a huge forklift truck onto the back of a wagon, but without realizing it, the wrong wagon. The wagon drove out of the hospital grounds immediately after, taking Baroness Thatched-Roof to a nearby coal yard, where he was driving to collect more coal for the hospital boilers. Once at the coal yard, the driver found the crate on the back of his wagon and heard Baroness Thatched-Roof crying out from behind, or rather inside, the crate. He opened the crate and was horrified to discover that Baroness Thatched-Roof was inside. He was forced to drive Baroness Thatched-Roof back to the hospital. Guy Fawkes Lift had fiendishly planned to put Baroness Thatched-Roof on top of his bonfire on Bonfire Night, which is an annual celebration of Guy Fawkes, held on November the 5th every year in the UK. His planned state cremation for Baroness Thatched-Roof was sadly thwarted. Cherie and Tony Blair-Witch have also been offered a place on the first commercial space flight from Earth to the Hubble Bubble Black Hole, formerly Calcutta, in outer space. Speculation is growing as to who else will get an invite on the first of many such space flights kindly offered by Branston-Pickles for a mere £2 million per ticket, a snip to those who have fleeced the UK taxpayer for a small fortune before retiring to act as puppeteers for their successors in power. Gordon Brown, another former UK Prime Minister, is tipped to be another such invited guest, and rumour has it that he will accept, given that he is as unpopular on Earth alongside Baroness Thatched-Roof, the Blair Witches, and also Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall, who has been had a name put forward by what is fondly known as the firm, this being the most senior members of the UK royal family. Bin Lid-Laden has nominated George W. Bush Baby and Barack Obama for the momentous first commercial spaceflight, whilst Barack Obama has nominated Bin Lid-Laden. A nice cosy flight already starting to emerge as the most famous departure in history of unpopular public figures. Branston-Pickles is set to make billions of pounds of it out of his new venture, as so many people are queuing up to nominate their pet hates for his obliging new commercial space flights. The flight will carry a passenger astronaut complement of six with two crew, and so Baroness Thatched-Roof, being the so-called Iron Lady, is tipped to be riding on the tail of the plane in an especially adapted ejector seat that will eject her into oblivion when the flight reaches the black hole, with the rest of the party travelling on into the black hole with two robotic crew at the helm. We shall let you know when to start celebrating the end of the Dark Ages in the wake of these famous space travellers reaching their hallowed destination aboard Virgin on the Evil, greedy, satanic flight 666. More news later. Watch this space, minus Branston Pickles and pet hates.